Hello students, so let us start our discussions again in our second video where we will try to understand mild slope case very clearly and then we will extrapolate the understanding that we develop for mild slope to steeper horizontal and adverse slope as well as critical slopes. So when we talk about mild slope, there are two things that we have learned with high confidence that a mild slope depth is going to be larger because velocities are going to be less. So to maintain same value of discharge, we need to have higher depths as compared to velocity heads. Now, if that is the case, we also learned that we will say that if our critical depth is YC, our normal depth of flow is going to be greater than critical depth of flow for section for a channel classified as M. Now you clearly see that we can divide this space into three regions. This is region 1, anything above the normal depth all the way till infinity. Region 2 is between YC and YN. And region 3 is between channel bed. This is region 2 and region 3. Region 3 is between channel bed and critical depth line. Whatever profile that would develop in section 1 would be called as M1. Whatever profile that would develop in section 2 would be M2. Whatever profile that we would have in part 3 would be classified as M3. But the question arises why these profiles will develop. So basically our channel is flowing smoothly at normal depth and downstream there is a dam. This dam is going to have some water stored at this particular level and this channel is coming all the way from hundreds of kilometers upstream of this dam. We have to connect point one to point two and we want to understand how this variation is going to look like. Is this variation going to be smooth? Is it going to justify the signs that we obtain from here? Or we cannot join 1 and 2 by a smooth line. There has to be some rapid transformation happening as we have in case of hydraulic jumps. So one thing is clear that for M1, our SF is less than S0 because here at point 2, our depth of flow is greater than normal depth. This is our normal depth and anything above this normal depth is greater than Y all the way till infinity. And we deduced that in last video that we can write this as SF is less than S0. That would mean that in case of dy by dx, our numerator is positive. When we talk about denominator, our denominator is governed by Froude number. Since we are talking about mild slope, and we are in region 3. In region 3, our depth of flow is greater than critical depth. Critical depth is somewhere here and we are talking about in region 1. So if our depth of flow is greater than critical depth, if you recall the variation between E and Y, we would say that if depth is greater than the critical depth, we are subcritical. And when we are subcritical, our Froude number is less than 1. So our denominator also has a sign of positive. So positive by positive would mean positive. That would mean that if this channel is coming, flowing around the normal depth of flow and it has to join a reservoir, there has to be increase in depth of flow. And this is possible for uniform variation without forming the hydraulic jump here because all these profiles were developed as if there is no loss. That's why we were able to write the Bernoulli's equation. If that is the case, question arises that now if this is our point 1 and point 2, what would be the magnitudes of slope at these points? Whether it would take off abruptly or it would be like this. This is also dy by dx is greater than 0 and this is taken care here. Or it will go like this, or it will take some straight point here without any curvature. So all these possibilities 1, 2, 3 are there. So again, we will go back to this equation and try to understand that what happens when we are closer to normal depth of flow. Now, when we are closer to yn, we learned that our s naught would be equal to sf, which implies our slope dy by dx would be equal to 0. So at this point of takeoff, we would have very smooth rise in the water level here, or the slope would be almost 0. And as we go upwards, this quantity becomes positive and it will keep on increasing in such a fashion. And the profile that we trace is called as the M1 flow. And this would continue until we reach the top of the water level in the dam. And this M1 profile is typically visible whenever a channel is trying to join a reservoir or a dam, and our slope of channel bed is classified as M. So if M1 is clear, let us look into second case. I have drawn a table here that in what cases, what kind of slopes develop. And we will talk about curvature also. Curvature is essentially governed by the sine of second derivative, and determining this sine of second derivative is not that straightforward. So we will assume that we have some functional form of fr is known. We have some dependencies of sf on y, and s naught is s naught. So based on that functional form, we should be able to determine this sine. But right now our focus should be first part, that whether water is going to rise or it is going to fall down, and then we will worry about the curvature later on. Now, in second case, what happens is that water was flowing at a normal depth, and suddenly, because we are talking about gradually varying flow, we put some gate at certain distance x from downstream. Now, when we have this gate here, we want to understand whether water would be able to flow smoothly or it would not be able to adjust to the variations, and it will go under some rapid transformation. Again, what we do, we see in this case, this is equal to yn, this is equal to yc. Now, our depth of flow is less than yn, because in region 2, we are always below yn, or at least asymptotically converging yn at the starting point. If that is the case, our sine of numerator is going to be negative, whereas our Froude number is still less than 1, because critical depth is here. Our actual depth of flow is in this region. Since our depth of flow is greater than critical depth, flow is still subcritical, as a result of which denominator will stay positive. And it tells us that there has to be a case where dy by dx decreases as we move along the x. And we call this profile as a drawdown profile. And this profile as the backwater profile. Where dy by dx is greater than 0, it traces backward profile. If it is less than 0, it traces the downward profile. Also, we have observed is that in case of M profiles, sine of dy by dx and sine of d square by dx square is same. That would mean if dy by dx is increasing, d square y by dx square should also be greater than 0. That would mean that it should be concaving upwards. Since in second case, our dy by dx comes out to be negative, negative divided by positive, it should be concaving downwards, or it should be convex upwards. Similarly, third case arises when we have this gate here and we are looking into sine of dy by dx. So in this case, now we would be in this region. This line happens to be our critical depth line. This happens to be normal depth line. Our depth of flow is lesser than normal depth of flow because there is some gate here and water is trying to pass under this gate. We have stopped water. This was a reservoir, and now you have some gate here. And in this case, we are in region 3. That is the practical case. But first of all, let's look into the sine. Since numerator is going to be negative, as sf is going to be greater than s naught because our depth of flow is less than normal depth of flow. Our Froude number now is going to be greater than 1. Why? Because this was our critical depth. We are in zone 3 And if we are in zone 3, this denominator becomes greater than 1. So this again becomes negative, negative. And that would mean that in direction of flow, our depth of flow should increase. And this is only possible that if we start from here and go in upward direction along the channel. And this profile M3 is generally observed when you have a setup where you have some reservoir. After reservoir, let me put a gate here. We have some gate here and water is held behind that. And then we suddenly start opening this gate. When we open this gate, and let us say that this is all built on a channel section, this water will try to escape from here. And it may happen that if this was our critical depth for that discharge, and given that it's a mild channel, our normal depth happens to be greater than YC, we would be zone 2 and our flow would be in the zone 3 area, and it will try to trace the M3 profile going upwards. So we will have M3, and as we learned that since this is positive, sine of d square y upon dx square is also having thus is going to have the sine of dy by dx in case of M profiles. So we will have a case of a backwater profile, and it would go in this fashion. So this is all the discussions about mild slope. Now I would request you, and we will cover this in our next video, is that can you derive all the three cases for a steep slope using same governing equation and same logic that we used here? Thank you.